Hello, beautiful people. Happy. Today is Tuesday. Oh my gosh, time flies. So I even forget the date. So anyway, I'm sure, you know, if you are at work now, you're just busy doing things, but you saw the topic of my video. It's housekeeping time. Let's dust things off, right? Hey, Kathy. Yeah, I'm not cleaning my house today. Mm-mm, that's what I meant. But I've been thinking about this topic since last week. Right? It's housekeeping time, let's dust things off. And why? I was just thinking, of course it's October, and I can't believe it's almost the end of the year, you know? 2020 is just around the corner. And of course, when it comes to the end of the year, we always start to think about, you know, what we had accomplished, you know, how, you know, the year is going so far, and, you know, the things that we did, the things that we didn't do it. And then we start just to challenge ourselves, right? And it's exactly what happened with me last week. I was just thinking, you know, about my year, my 2019, and I just one point I realized, like, oh, it's been a great year. And then when I thought about it's been a great year, I also thought about it, but it's been a difficult year. And then Kayla, how can it be a great year and a difficult year at the same time? And then as I was thinking about, you know, all the challenges, you know, that I faced this year, you know, and all the blessings that I had, and I had been able to overcome the challenge too. And then I was thinking about housekeeping, you know, dust things off, because it's exactly how I felt this year. I felt that I was doing housekeeping and dusting things off all year long, cleaning, doing a big cleaning. And one thing about housekeeping, I always think about, okay, cleaning our house. And then I realized that, you know, when I'm cleaning my house, you don't want to come here when I'm cleaning my house. Hey, Sherita, good afternoon. You don't want to come here because it gets really messy, you know, and overwhelming when I'm deciding to do housekeeping and I'm dusting things off and I'm organizing stuff here at my house. It gets very messy because I don't know how to clean just from the mirror. You know, like sometimes, you know, you have somebody to come to clean your house. They just clean the center, they sweep the floor, you know, but everything, they don't move the furniture, you know, they don't clean the refrigerator, they don't open the microwave to clean the microwave. They just clean just superficial in the center. So when I'm cleaning my house, right, and I'm just giving some examples so we can apply for our lives as well, right? Hey, beautiful Rin. I do the same thing. I can't just clean my house just like superficial. If I'm gonna go a cleaning, I'm gonna do a real cleaning. And then I'm referring this to my life, I'm referring this to my house. And it's funny because when this card comes home and I'm cleaning myself, I have a housekeeper here help me. He looks around and say, oh boy, because he knows it's gonna take me the whole day to clean. Because I take everything from the drawers, I move everything, I fold one by one, I find out which one I want to keep it of my clothes, so, you know, things around the house, and the ones that I don't want to keep it, I give away. I move the furniture out and everything has just come to the center of the room. It just is a mess. As a mess. And then, by the end of the day, when I'm done, it's nice and neat and clean, right? But one point when I'm there just doing this cleaning, I get overwhelmed. And, why I start this, you know? Because it's overwhelming sometimes, right? But I did start, and in the end of the day, I feel glad that I did. But how this apply to my life? Because one point this year, because I've been doing housekeeping and dusting things off in my life, right, all year long. And then one point I really thought, oh my gosh, my life looks messy. Things were a little messy. And I was just, you know, as I was cleaning, you know, doing things the way I want and just the way I just dusting things off, removing things and people in my life that I didn't think meant to be there. Things got a little messy one point, and then it's scary, right? And I say, oh my gosh, am I doing the right thing? You know, why I'm going to this direction? It's creating me some pain and I'm getting uncomfortable because I say, like, you know, we are creatures of habits. We get comfortable, you know, doing the same thing. So when we decided to make some change, change can be challenge, can be painful, it hurts, and, you know, and it's like I said, it can be a challenge. So that's exactly how I felt with 2019. And then when I see now that we're coming towards to the end of the year, I'm glad that I start, you know, to do the house cleaning, and I start to do dust things off from the beginning. I keep doing, even at the time that I was overwhelming and I thought, oh, I can't finish this, I can't get it done, you know, I kept doing, you know. Now that is almost, you know, mid-October, and I'm coming just ready just to write my new year resolution for 2020, and I really recommend you to start it now, right? Just look at back what you have done, what you have accomplished so far, what you like about you, about your life, about your things that's going on in your life, what you didn't like it. Listen, every day is a new day. We have a blank page and we can start over. Yes, we can start over. And by the way, we do mistakes, but we learn with our own mistakes, right? And that's my point here for you today. And when I was reflecting in my life, where I stand today, how 2019 was a good year, but at the same time, a year that got, you know, a lot of challenges for me, right? And then a year that I was growing, evolving, and doing things different, because it's hard to get different results doing the same thing over and over and over, right? And listen, people around you, you know, when you start to dust things off and you are cleaning, you know, your life, people around you may not gonna understand why you're going to that path. You may be you not gonna understand, because I had times in my life, hi Silvana, this year, you know, as I was dusting things off in my life, I was doing the housekeeping in my life, and I was asking myself, and I say, Kiola, are you doing the right thing? Right? So every other day I need some affirmation from friends, from people that loves me, you know, and then I could see God is speaking to me through others to let me know I was in the right path, I was doing the right thing, right? And of course, you know, the haters were there to tell me that, you know, I was doing something wrong and I'm not doing something right. But I'm not gonna listen what they have to say, because I know who I am, I know my identity, and I know my purpose is my purpose, it's not your purpose. It's like, you know, and the same way, your purpose is your purpose, it's not my purpose. Sometimes what makes sense for me doesn't make sense for you, or vice versa. So that's why, folks, you know, like we always talk about, like, you know, especially in spring, right? We say, you know, this is spring cleaning, right? I think, you know, for me, spring cleaning this year was all year I was doing spring cleaning, and I still doing cleaning, you know, and dusting things off. And it's very important, you know, again, comes towards the year, you know, if you want to start fresh, you know, have your blank page, and you can write whatever you want in that blank page of your life. That's what I'm telling you, right? As 2020 is just around the corner. Yeah, and don't be afraid. Get out of your comfort zone. Make the change that you need to do to, you know, get different results in your life. And again, things can be messy. And I tell you here, this girl here can tell you, I had times this year that my life got so messy that I even didn't know how I could handle, you know. But now I can see it's getting neat, you know, towards the end of the year, and I feel in peace, and I feel like, okay, I think I did the right thing, and I'm still on the right path. So yeah, don't be afraid of the mess. Remember what I tell you all the time, you know, after the storm, it comes the rainbow, you know. And being a boater those days, I know, because I'm in the water all the time, on the water, I see, you know, when we have a storm, you know, and the river get really messy and bumpy water, and you know, and it's just, I see, like, it's the end of the day, is always we have the best sunsets, the most beautiful sunsets. That's the same thing every time when I see my life, when I'm doing, you know, housekeeping and dusting things off, and things get a little messy and I get overwhelmed, I always think about, by the end, when I finish that, I'm gonna enjoy, you know, my beautiful, you know, neat life, and the mess is gonna be gone. So you just don't have, you know, just don't give up, right? You know, and then sometimes it's important, because if we don't do housekeeping, dust things off, what happens? Things start to pile up, pile up, and it's hard for you to fix it later, to just to get that thing neat, you know, take the mess away. So that's why I started now, you know, and this is the perfect time of the year to do, you know, your housekeeping, to dust things off, to remove the things, the people that don't belong to your life, that doesn't add anything to your life. If they don't add anything positive to your life, there is no reason to be there. And I'm talking about things, I'm talking about people as well. Yeah, because we all have our friends, we had our family, and but we grow, we evolve. If our friends, you know, they are not aligned with our purpose, doesn't mean they are not bad. Folks, we have different times, you know, in our life, right? And it does mean like, but if the person, you know, your friends hold you back for where you meant to be, let them go. Bless them, love them, let them go. But don't let them hold you back. It's very important, folks, okay? And I always refer this, we gotta free up space, give yourself room, because, and I had make always refer to this, because sometimes God has a Ferrari to deliver to your garage now, today, you know, but you're so attached to that Ford that you keep in your garage, so you don't free up room in your garage to God deliver, you know, your Ferrari that's ready for you. That's what I meant, folks. Just free up space. Do some housekeeping. Let's dust things off. Let things and people go that they don't mean to be in your life, right? They not may not gonna agree with you. They don't have to. But that's the point of my video here, you know, today for you. And I think it's the right time to do that. It's October, mid-October 2020. It's just around the corner. And as I'm thinking about my life today and what is my goal for 2020, what I've been through this year, you know, and I thought I have to share this with you because I think it's so important, folks. All right, so that's my message for today, you know, just give some thoughts. It's time to do some housekeeping. It's the perfect time of the year. It's time to dust things off, all right? And just always remember, be you, do you, stay true to yourself. All right, folks, I love you all. Have a good day. Bye-bye.